watching TV. Al Linder told me, kid, go get yourself a tackle box, and that's just what I did. But now it sits here empty, without a lure inside. When I see those fishermen casting, I hang my head and cry. Like a limestone cowboys, climbing through a land full of danger and mystery. Like a limestone cowboys, exploring unknown passages and making history. Places most others won't see.
Welcome to Whitewater State Park, where the trees are tall, the limestone is strong, and of course, the visitors are all above average. So, it's up here, so I'm Kate.
I'm Sarah.
And again, tonight we'll be talking a little bit about water issues. We also do have a few special guests lined up, so hopefully they'll all be able to make it tonight. And I think we'll, wait a minute. I think we're getting a news fax in. I'm Kate with SEMN News. We actually have a lucky treat here tonight. Some of you have seen this field reporter that we have that goes out and checks things out for us. And tonight we're fortunate to have him back again. So let's give a big round of applause for Tony Gossa.
So yeah, I got some juicy little tidbits for you, Kate.
Okay, spill.
This has been this proclamation, I guess. And the governor made this proclamation that this year, 2017, is the year of water catching. The year of water catching.
Water catching?
Water catching.
What?
I swear. So we're supposed
I'm
to all go out
sure
and catch water.
That's not right.
I'm what? Pretty sure that's
no.
You
know, the governor has been talking about, you know, just because you say it higher doesn't make it true. The governor has been talking a lot about pollution and water action and runoff and things like that, trying to hold soil in place and keep pollution out of the streams.
No, I'm pretty sure that's not it. But, okay, so I got one last little bit of news now. I think I brought this up a year or two ago, but it's back in the news, these butter strips.
Butter strips?
Yeah, now, it's a big deal, because some people are saying, it's like a big controversy, some people are saying, no margarine. Margarine what? Is what we should be using instead of the butter strips.
No, okay. I remember that. That was a couple of years ago. I thought we cleared this up. Buffer strips,
no.
The buffer strip initiative. To plant the grasses along the streams, and it protects things from running into the streams.
That's not it.
And then you were saying something about the butter making the trout taste better, but
that's
the buffer strip.
Please, I don't understand why this is a debate, because margarine, you know, they say margarine is synthetic, and your body can't even process it. It just goes in your butt cheeks forever. So to me, it's like, why are we debating over this? Because butter is so delicious, and you can process it.
Well,
yeah, I got to get rolling, because I got another juicy little tidbit. I'm meeting up with an oral hygienist here in the park, because he's collecting cavities. True story. Yeah, that was in the paper. There was like a big press release that went out. So I'm gonna go check this
oral
out.
Oral histories.
No, it's oral hygienist. I know it. I got you.
Well, all right, you go see if you can clear that up. Thanks
no,
a lot.
Take care.
Tony.
We'll
thanks
see y'all later.
Thanks for joining us. I think maybe he's really going to a dentist, but I think he's talking about 2019 is going to be Whitewater's 100th anniversary. So they're doing a lot of collection of oral histories of the valley. Well, that's great. Bob Ross is a pretty amazing painter. We couldn't get Bob Ross tonight, but we do have his cousin, brother, I think it's his brother, Bob Moss coming in.
Well, hello, everybody.
Welcome to the joy of painting in nature. I'm Bob Moss. Tonight we're going to paint a happy little stream, is what we're going to paint here. Now tonight I'm using just the standard, my favorite color. We got a little phthalo blue, a little liquid white, a little cad yellow, sap green, and my all-time favorite, Van Dyke brown. Now I've already used a series of crisscrosses and my liquid white to get my canvas prepared here. And I'd like to welcome all of you who are first-timers joining us tonight to, you know, bring your easels on out and join along with us. It's really a happy little time here. So we're going to paint a happy little stream. And to get started here, there's a few kind of criteria that a stream has to have to really be happy. So I'm going to go on in here and I'm going to get me some phthalo blue. I should mention I'm using a 1-inch fan brush. I'm dipping in my phthalo blue if I can see it through my mossy here. I can do that. So I'm going to put a nice little boulder in. Let's say right there. Isn't that thing? Now, I think everybody deserves a friend. So I'm going to give this little boulder a friend. Right there. There. Now, the most important component to a happy little stream is the floodplain. The floodplain. Mm-hmm. Floodplain is the area of land on each side of the stream. And when you get a lot of rain or snowmelt, the river overflows into its floodplain. And the floodplain is part of the river. The river isn't just water rolling across the ground. It's got a whole ecosystem, and the floodplain is part of that. So we're going to use us a little sap green here to represent our floodplain area. Now, I just made it generic, but at home, this is your world. And in your painting, you can do whatever you want. So you can make cottonwood trees or ash trees, willow trees, whatever little buggers you want to have in there. So please make sure you join me next time when my son Steve will be here. He's a fantastic painter, and he will show you how to paint a happy little beaver dam. So join me next time.
I'm really glad you came. Thank you. You've been doing this a long time, right?
Well, this is
it looks a little more, maybe your 16th season?
55th
season? Wow. I looks a little like a dragon there, Petra, outside. And no offense, I guess I just kind of expected a little more.
Let me say something here. I am a moss. Well, okay, so that I can hold a paintbrush in these hands is quite a miracle.
All right. I'm sorry.
Waders on and our flies all tied, and we're walking up the creek. Deer flies are buzzing and the horse flies are biting, and they're making us free, making it ready. Across the riffle where the logs are jammed is where the fish are at. Long ones, short ones, round ones, thin ones, and ones that are fat. Baby, get ready. Ooh, you and me going fishing in the park. If we catch our limit, I'll be happy as a lark when we get back home.
Coolness hangs in the air. All around me. Droplets fall around me, on me. Smell the freshness of the air, the renewal arising. Release. The rain has stopped now. Mother Earth feels new again. No? Cleansed, moistened, anew, refreshed. Refresh. clowns are naturalists, not performers.
We don't need a motor, we don't need a sail, we don't need no fins or gills, we don't need a tail. Let's just keep it simple, we'll each grab an oar, paddle out to no man's lake and float till we can no more.
Lady Nord, Park Ranger. Lady Nord, Park Ranger, protecting our resources. It was a hot, muggy day, and I was practicing my Darth Vader voice in my office.
Luke, I am your father.
When an urgent call came over the park radio.
Breaker, breaker 19, we have a possible Loch Ness monster near the river by the picnic shelter.
Well, I ran out of my office, grabbed my ranger bicycle, and pedaled as fast as I could. I rang the bell on my bicycle. The brown and gold streamers from the handlebars blew in my face. As I picked up my bicycle, I heard a woodpecker off in the distance. And then noticed some very strange tracks. I asked two Australians who were out for a hike if they had seen anything strange, and they replied,
"Crikeys, now that'll get you Grundies in a bunch, but we've got us an Akura. I mean a fair dinkum-Akura on the loose. It ain't no furfy."
Well, I wasn't actually sure what they said, but the word Akura sounded spooky. As I pedaled further down the road, I heard a crow call out. I neared the trail to the picnic shelter, and a barred owl called. I ran down the path. As I ran down the path, I heard a coyote call out. Well, I came across a small group of Swedish exchange students doing...
By Odin's beard! We heard that too! Sounds like it was coming from Valhalla, yeah?
The exchange students pointed downstream and I headed that direction. Another call came over my radio.
Breaker, breaker 19. Lady Nord, you're needed right away. Someone has reported a Yeti on the Overlook Trail.
But that's another chapter in the exciting story of Lady Nord, Park Ranger.
She's been everywhere.
Entertained a little bit and maybe learned a little bit about water.
Good night, campers. Good night, campers. Good night, campers. It's time to say good night.